Hi, it's Carrie. I'm a health professions librarian at Towson University's Albert S. Cook Library. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to search in PubMed with MeSH, Medical Subject Headings. PubMed is a platform from the National Library of Medicine and the National Center for Biotechnology Information. PubMed has three major components: Medline, PubMed Central, and the NCBI bookshelf. We have access to PubMed through the Cook Library. It is also freely available on the web, but if you access it through the Cook Library, you'll get access to all of our subscription content. You can access PubMed by clicking on the Databases button from our website, which is libraries.towson.edu. And we'll search for PubMed. And we'll access PubMed. And what we're going to do today is explore the MeSH database, which is down here under Explore on the right. So we're not looking for literature, we're looking for subject headings, medical subject headings, or MeSH. So let's say we were interested in literature about hearing loss. We can enter some search terms here and see what we get. If any of these suggested terms work, you can choose those. Otherwise, you can just press enter. And we get some entries, specific types of hearing loss. The main one here up at the top looks like the broadest term for hearing loss, and there are some related terms here. But I'm going to choose number one. So here we have the definition of the term. If this were a term with any ambiguity, you could always check and make sure it's the one that you want. We have the year introduced, which means that this was a new term in 2003. And when we search with this term, we're going to find literature going back to 2003, when it was introduced. We have subheadings, which are subheadings to help you find literature on specialized topics. So if you were interested in hearing loss and rehabilitation, or hearing loss and statistics and numerical data, you could check those boxes. Then we have restrict to major MeSH topic. So that's saying find literature where hearing loss is a major topic. And then we have do not include MeSH terms found below this term in the MeSH hierarchy. Now what does that mean? Let me show you. If we scroll down the page, at the bottom of the MeSH entry, we see the MeSH hierarchy. So this term appears on three branches, and the broader terms are up above it, so hearing disorders, ear diseases, and the narrower terms are below it. So if we search with the MeSH term hearing loss, we're automatically going to be searching all of these terms as well. If these terms weren't relevant or if that was too broad for us, we can check that box. Do not include MeSH terms found below this term in the MeSH hierarchy. And that would narrow our search down a little bit to just literature that's been indexed with hearing loss. Here we see some entry terms, and these might be some suggested keywords you could add to your search to make it broader and more robust. But today we just want to search with the MeSH term, hearing loss. So over here on the right-hand side, we see the PubMed search builder, and we're going to click Add to Search Builder. We get hearing loss, it's in quotes, and we get what's called a field tag or a field descriptor that says MeSH. So it's telling PubMed, which is a platform of 32 million records at this time, to find literature that's been indexed with hearing loss. So we can click Search PubMed. Now out of those 32 some million records, there are 71,170 results that have been indexed with hearing loss. Let's take a look at one of these records. I'm going to scroll down the page and click on number 7. And here we see the title, the citation information, and the authors, and the abstract. And if we keep scrolling below similar articles, we see MeSH terms. So these are other MeSH terms that have been assigned to this article. So it's also about age. It's also about audiometry, pure tone, cognition, cross-sectional studies, and so on. But you see hearing loss here, and that asterisk means that actually this is a major topic of this article. let's go back. And let's say, obviously, that 71,000 results are too many for us to go through, so we do want to narrow it down a little bit. We can do that. PubMed is saving our search history as we go along, so we can navigate back to the PubMed homepage by clicking on the logo, and we can navigate back to MeSH, which is under Explore. And let's say we were interested in literature about hearing loss and dementia. So we can search for dementia. And really, we'll just want to stay broad, so we'll pick this first one. Here's our definition. And then we have a year introduced, and what this means is this term was introduced in 1981, but retroactively indexed back to 1963. So if we search with this term, we're going to find literature going back to 1963. Then we see those subheadings again, we see some entry terms, and we see the MeSH hierarchy. We're going to click Add to Search Builder. Again, we get the term in quotes with the MeSH tag, and click Search PubMed. So you'll see these kind of work like a hashtag. We're finding all this literature that's been tagged with this term. We have 173,674 results. And again, we could look at any of those, scroll down to find the MeSH terms, and see that, in fact, dementia is here, and it is a major topic again. All right, so we want to combine the two. So we're going to go back. Now, it's not totally clear, but our search history is saved under Advanced. So our browsing session search history is under Advanced, and here we will see our two searches. And what we want to do is click on the ellipses. It doesn't matter which one, either one, but we'll choose number one first and say Add Query. It pops up here to the query box, and then we'll say for number two, Add with AND. So we're saying to PubMed, find us literature that has both the index terms or medical subject headings, hearing loss and dementia. So we had quite a lot of results earlier. Let's see what happens now. We'll click search, and we have 280 results, which is a much more manageable set of results. You can play with the filters over here on the left. You can edit or revise your search. I hope you learned something new from this video. Leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you find it helpful. Librarians are here to help, and I would be thrilled to hear from you.